हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग टुडे स्टाफिंग एज अ पार्ट ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट। वी ऑल नो द मीनिंग ऑफ द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट एंड हियर इट इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ प्लानिंग फॉर रिक्रूटिंग द required staff and also for development process to achieve the goals and objectives of enterprise. So you understand one thing, that every industries in these days today is having one HR department, Human Resource Department, which is in short explained as HRD. In India, this is somehow new concept, and the managers are associated with this. Human Resource Management are known as HR managers. If we understand the staffing process, it includes recruitment, selection, appointment, training, promotion. But it also includes some facilities to provide to the employees. Thereafter, if any enterprise want to get best performance with satisfaction, they need to think about progressive wage system, so the employees should not be disturbed by performing dull. So basic concept of the human resource management is get the best from the employee and find out the best employee by the experts of the human resource and try to provide welfare to the employees. So as the earlier people were thinking, what's the meaning of staff? The people were thinking that just to fulfilling the post, nothing else. But nowadays human resource management is become most essential part of any organizational structure. So in these days we cannot deny the importance of the global competition, where our enterprises have also to be included. So the importance of human resource management has been increased, and due to that, by considering so many factors, we need to get best results. We are trying to get best staff. So the loyalty, efficiency, skill, performance, satisfaction in the job, everything should be fulfilled and the best performance should come out. So this is a process of human resource management. So you have already understood the question. Explain the staffing as the part of human resource management, right? So now I'm discussing the division of human resource management. There are two divisions. First is associated with MPP. MPP means manpower planning. And second one is associated with compensation to the staff and development of the staff. So different aspects have been included here. So first I'm discussing about the manpower planning. To plan to get the best staff for the organization and increase the staff through new appointments. This is the first concept. Second one is, as per the time and situation required, select the staff as it is required only, not to reduce the all staff members, but who are additionally in company are creating burden on the expenses should reduce, but the required staff should be maintained. The third aspect is, the third concern is appropriate placement of the staff. See, I discussed the concept of the appropriate placement means right person on the right post as per the qualification which is required, as per the requirement of the staffing, the person is needed, is allowed, but less qualified person will not be allowed. Next point is, keep the staff constantly active and enhance, increase their knowledge so they should provide best output from their side. Second one is, see, here we have discussed about concern with the manpower planning. So here, see, I'm explaining some aspect of this topic. As we have understood the required staff, so which are required should keep in company, but who are additional, if it is not required, then don't continue, but try to provide them as much as better work and try to get better performance from them. Thereafter, if the time is not proper in the situation of the market, then reduce the additional staff. It does not mean the remove many staff, but additional who are not required or who are not performing well, remove them. That is the point. And lastly, I discussed that keep the staff active with knowledge. And here the additional study, capacity, performance is required to be taken in mind. If the training is given, additional degrees are provided, then their performance will be seen. Otherwise, it is not possible. So the best knowledge is required to give. Is that clear? So this is the concern part of manpower planning. Now I am discussing about concern with the compensation. Compensation means reimburse the person if he is being removed. Then here we have to understand that if any person is being removed, compensate him for doing his work, or if he is in the company, then give him proper remuneration in time, and also try to give them training so their development in actual aspect become possible. Now we discuss the four points relating to the concern with compensation and development of staff. To provide work related training to the staff whenever necessary means training is for the development of the person and ultimately associated with the company achievement of goal. Second point, provide conducive environment, happy environment where the person can do the work by heart with inner satisfaction and without any complaint. Opportunity, provide them to improve their performance, proficiency or efficiency so they can provide their best to the company in getting the remuneration as the best they are asking. They can provide the best. Okay. To give proper compensation, see, as I am talking just before, compensation means give the money for his work or the job whatever he is doing. So company provide enough remuneration, salary, amount, whatever we can say, but it is in one word said to be compensation for their work. It can be said as a reimbursement, reimbursing means for whatever the efforts they are doing, getting the money. Benefits to the staff, benefits means money for the rent, medical allowance, leave, travel, so many things are included in the benefit. And mainly after the completion of the job, years should provide them specific amount so can he spend his retired life in proper manner. So here some companies are not giving importance to satisfy the person but wants to get the working better. It is not proper. So every company has to compensate their staff, satisfy them, fulfill their benefits and get their best as their work. The fourth point is coming, recognize work related problems, means you identify their problems so they should be satisfied by getting the solution of their problems relating to the job environment sometime. So if your staff is happy, the work will be done in better manner. This is the concept which is universally accepted. So here I always remember the line used and stated by Professor Urwarik, maintain your man will mind everything for you. So give proper attention to your staff, they will do everything, whatever they can do for you. This is the basic essence behind this concept. Understand this. Okay, now we are discussing in concern to this topic about some essential point which I want to discuss. According to human resource management, employees are not only factor for the production, but they are more than that. They are valuable asset of the company. Invaluable asset, I could say, because without the man, your machines cannot do the work. Some people says that I am having the automatic machines, but who will operate? The living staff is required to operate the machinery. Means machines are essential, but to operate the machines, living staff is also essential with the skill and efficiency they are needed. Okay, they are considered as a human element also. This is the second word. Earlier I used the word invaluable assets. Their value is not counted by the money. Second, I said as a human element, they are humans. Give them importance as a human being. Not only think that they are factor of production, but think that they are living persons. Sometime company give relaxation to the employee. Why? Not only to see that they are working, they may relieve. No. But as they are working, they are giving their best to the company. So company is also progressing, getting profit. But if you are not giving importance to them, your staff will not continue for a long with you with heart. If they are unnecessarily, they are necessarily stayed with you, it is okay. But unnecessarily they will leave you because they don't find happiness with you. So they will leave you. Here remember one thing, increasing the efficiency of the staff and provide the job satisfaction to the employee is also part of our study of human resource management. So remember one thing, any company must be successful only with the efficient staff. If working efficiently and performing well with goal achieving abilities. So, organizational objectives and individual objectives both are necessary to be achieved. So, the company should feel that their performance is better. Right, my friends?